After you've formulated your legal research question, the next question is, so what am I going to use to find the answer? What stuff do I need to analyze to find the answer to my question? So natural scientists, they do experiments. They go to a laboratory and they do their experiments. But what do lawyers analyze? What is the international lawyer's laboratory? That's not so clear. So when it comes to identifying the stuff that you as an international lawyer need to examine, you first, of course, resort to the formal sources of international law. That's the process of international lawmaking, treaty making, formation of customary international law, and the identification of general principles. And then you look at the outcome of these processes, and those are then the material source of international law. And they include specific treaties, such as the United Nations Charter, but also specific UN Security Council resolutions binding on the entire UN membership. So international lawyers study the interpretation, application, and interrelation of these sources of international law. And evidence of these sources and of their application, interpretation, and continuous evolution can also be found in judgments. Think of judgments of the International Court of Justice or the International Criminal Court. You can also look at the work of the International Law Commission, think of the ILC's articles on state responsibility, United Nations reports, think of the Brundtland Commission's report on sustainable development, academic publications, NGO reports, and so on. And when it comes to custom, finding support for a customary norm specifically, you might also want to refer to descriptions of state practice and opinion juris that have some authority. Many governments, they keep a digest of state practice of their country, but you can also look at government memos, memos produced by the government.